Another way of thinking about a classifier's decision process is through discriminant functions. And this is all about choosing some functions. So we would say choose some functions gi of x, and they would be one for each one of our classes in such a way that our decision process is going to be, so we can output class ci for our input if the discriminant function I is the one assuming the maximum value among all of these discriminant functions on input x. And so this is all about maximizing some well-chosen discriminant functions, whereas our discussion before was about minimizing the risk of misclassification. And as a matter of fact, what we discussed before about the Bayes classifier can easily be turned into the case of discriminant functions. And you can do it like this. For the Bayes classifier, you can just simply choose these discriminant functions to be gi of x, to be simply minus the risk of taking decision alpha I, in other words, the risk of taking of outputting class I for input x. Now, in the case we are using 0, 1 loss functions, this becomes all about gi of x being the probability of class ci given input x. And this is according to, Bayes' rule, this was the probability of x given ci times the probability of ci divided by the probability of x. And of course, because our decision process is all about maximizing these values, it doesn't really matter that all of these values are calculated as a division by p of x. So we could just ignore this division by p of x. So another way, which is going to be just as good, and in fact with a simpler function, is simply to choose gi of x to be simply this product probability of x given ci times the probability of ci. And so this effectively leads to a decision process where we have k decision regions. And what I mean by this is that we will have one region for each class, and the region is going to be for class I, we will have this decision R, so this decision region consisting of all input points where gi of x is the maximum one among all of these discriminant functions. So all the points falling into decision region Ri will get as an output, will be classified in class Ci. And so visually speaking, we have a situation like this where we have these, in our case, on this example, three decision regions. And any point, any input falling into one of these regions will have a clear decision. Now, the space in between the decision regions is all about inputs for which the maximum discriminant function on that input is not unique, meaning that this is a case of doubt. We don't really know, you know, unambiguously which class to assign to this input. And depending on our application, this would be a case where we would decline to take a decision. So we would reject a decision on this input. In the case we are dealing only with two classes, this is called a dichotomizer in terms of a classifier. And in fact, if we had more than two classes, this would be a polychotomizer. But in the case of a dichotomizer with only two classes, one possibility is to choose such a discriminant function, g of x, to be equal to g1 of x minus g2 of x. And our decision process simply will be, you know, choose class 1 if g of x is larger than 0, and choose c2 otherwise. And one possibility in this case is to choose as the discriminant function the so-called log odds, which is the logarithm of this probability of c1 given x divided by the probability of c2 given x.